All right, what's up, guys? My name is Gavin Aiden, and today I'm going to be making like a hybrid video. The primary focus of it is to review the Rep Fitness Power Rack. I believe it's the P1000 or RP1000. It's the most affordable option. And then also their comp bench, which is right over here, which I think is absolutely beautiful. So I ordered it last Sunday. Now, given the whole coronavirus situation, this is probably important for me to say prior to reviewing it. Given the whole coronavirus situation, I was looking for equipment that not only was reputable and good, but that would also ship fast, right? Because all gyms are closed, I need to lift. So I was looking at Rogue, I was looking at Ethos, Vulcan was one that somebody recommended to me, and Strength Training Systems, of course. So obviously a lot of Elite FTS, a lot of companies to choose from. I went with them strictly because they have fast shipping time. So shipping 1 to 3 business days. I ordered it on Sunday, came here yesterday, Friday. So it took about 4 to 5 days. And then the build time for this was about 2 hours. The build time for the bench was about 1 hour. So really not that bad. All I needed was a wrench or like a ratchet. And they also give you tools too. So you don't need to actually have the tools necessarily, but you know, obviously it would help if you had some power tools. And that's pretty much it. So the reason why I'm making a hybrid video is because today I have an SBD day of squat, bench, deadlift, which I have almost every single Saturday now. And today I'm working up to a top squat single of 650. This would be a PR for me. I'll also be working up to a top double, which would be a PR for my bench. However, the 650 is what's important. The reason why is because this is my first time using this rack. So we're gonna see if this thing can stand it, if this thing can hold up. We'll see how it feels so far. The rack height and stuff like that just during warm-up seems perfect. The only complaint so far, if you come over here, or you can even come through here, is the width between the first stand and the second. It's a little narrow. It's not ideal, especially if you're someone like me who I have big walkouts. I like to come up really calm, composed, tight, and then take a nice solid step back. I'm finding as of right now that my inner plate keeps hitting this stand. So really that's just me being cognizant of that. I have to make sure that I don't, you know, do that too often, or at least not on the heavy stuff. But yeah, that's the only complaint so far. If you see these plates here, these are just because I like to squat facing out, and this is gonna be the case with any rack unless your rack weighs well over like 300 fucking pounds or more. It's gonna come forward when you re-rack your weight. So I put these plates down. Honestly, if I can find even more weight, I might put more down just to keep it from sliding forward. But yeah, my only other concern going into this is gonna be the back. So the more weight that I load, the harder I rack, the more chance that there is that this is gonna kind of tip forward, which is exactly what we don't want. So I might put some gravel down and stuff like that, some sandbags. But yeah, that's pretty much it. Stay tuned. I'm gonna film some warm-ups and stuff like that, definitely the top sets. And then I'm gonna do a finale, like a big review of everything, including the bench, at the end of the workout, because I'll have used everything. So, cool. So squats went pretty well, the rack's holding up well. Honestly, it actually feels really good. The width that I was talking about before really wasn't much of an issue as it was during warm-up, so that's good. I think it was just about adjusting to it. However, I will definitely have to put weight, whether it be sandbags, bags of gravel, whatever, on all corners, because the cage kind of keeps shifting, which honestly, you're gonna experience that shit with anything, like a combo rack, to power racks, half racks, all of it. So Easy fix. Gonna hit the top set on bench, which would be a PR. It's 4:30 for two. Pause. So yeah, gonna hit that in a few minutes, and it's gonna be powered by Fitz Buds, my fucking go-to, and a nice fat turkey sandwich. So let's get it. Tango, she keep on my chip, I said, sipping no survey, ain't driving no boo boo. Me and this girl, she don't know which one coaches, we think that she shit, but I'm buying them both. We on Rodeo, no book, I just heat it. I walk on my pair, my head to a coat, I can live out my closet. Too many cars, ain't thinking, no, too many tangos. She keep on my chip, I said, sipping no survey, ain't driving no boo boo. Me and this girl, she don't know which one coaches, we think that she shit, but I'm buying them both. I didn't know you were doing that. Okay, so after a long training day, I'm gonna kind of provide like a nice finale review of the equipment. Long story short, the bench is phenomenal, absolutely worth it. I think the bench costs like $175 or $150, which is super, super cheap for a competition grade bench. Again, just really hands down, great fucking product. The rack, looking back, I would probably spend an extra $100 or $200 to get the next best. This is the cheapest power rack they have, I think. This costs like $250, I wanna say, or $275, something like that. However it works out, both the rack and the bench came out to about $400. The rack is good, it's worth it. It didn't break, nothing came undone, so that's a plus. However, it is kinda light, so after every single re-rack, both on squats and bench, the whole thing would shift and shake and stuff like that. Again, I trust the durability of the product, but you do feel it. You know, it's kind of scary, especially when you have a lot of weight on your back or over you. So, yeah, again, I think it's absolutely worth it. I really do enjoy it. The colors are great. One other downside, though, that you're going to experience with any product is it's starting to chip. So you probably wouldn't be able to see with the camera, but in there, in here, if you put weight over here, it's the paint. Let's see if I can find here, like right over here. I don't know if you guys can see that, but yeah, there's like little marks like that all over now, which is just a little annoying. Again, like it was under $300, which is tough to find, not to mention it shipped in literally a week. So I'm not complaining, but it is a little annoying because I really like the fucking color and I would love for it to stay this way. But yeah, that's pretty much it. I mean, everything else seems really durable, really good. Like I said, the bench is amazing. Yeah. If you buy it, put some sandbags and shit around on each corner and you should be good. But this was an A+, so.